Hi, I'm Jeremy Stafford from Mossberg. Today we're going to talk about administratively loading and unloading the Mossberg 500 and 590 series of shotguns. Now, before we can get to the loading and unloading, we need to verify the condition of the shotgun. First thing we need to do is ensure that the shotgun is on safe. With the 500 and 590 series of shotguns, that ambidextrous safety lever needs to be all the way to the rear. Once we've verified that that lever is all the way to the rear, we can go ahead and open the action. To do that, we're going to depress the action release lever by pushing it all the way into the frame. Now I can bring that fore end all the way to the rear, opening the action. Once the action is open, I can physically and visually inspect the magazine tube and the firing chamber to make sure that it is free from any ammunition, and I can also make sure that there's no debris or excess lubrication. Now, before I load the shotgun, what I'm going to do is I'm going to verify I'm utilizing the right ammunition. In most cases, that information is going to be on the left side of the barrel. All right, for the sake of the video, I'm utilizing dummy rounds, and I'm also going to show you how to load directly into the chamber. In this case, I'm going to take this dummy round, brass to the rear, and just let it fall into the ejection port. Once it does so, you'll see that the shell elevator maintains control of it, and as I bring the forend forward, it brings the shell to the appropriate level, and it allows those dual extractors to maintain control of that shell as it moves into the firing chamber. Now, at this point, I have a round chambered. Even though there's no ammunition inside the magazine tube, there's still a round in the chamber, so I'm going to make sure that safety stays on and my finger stays off of the trigger. To place ammunition into the magazine tube, I'm going to invert the shotgun so that that loading port is facing upwards. I'm going to take these rounds, once again, brass to the rear, maintain control, and use my thumb to press it into the magazine tube. I'm going to press it far enough forward that I feel and hear that cartridge stop snap as it takes control of the rear of the shell. At no point am I going to try to put more rounds into that magazine tube than it can handle. That's how you damage the shotgun. Now, at this point, I have a shotgun that's completely loaded and ready to deploy. Now, what about downloading and unloading the shotgun? All right, the act of downloading the shotgun is simply taking that round out of the chamber and securing it elsewhere. Now, to do that, I'm going to once again depress that cartridge lever. I'm going to maintain control of the shotgun between my arm and my body, and I'm going to ease that forend to the rear. Once I bring it back, you can see those dual extractors maintaining control. And it's going to clear that chamber, and that elevator will come up and make sure that it doesn't fall through. I'm going to keep pulling back, and then once that elevator starts to drop out of the way, I can reach in and I can manually remove that shell from the shotgun. Once I've done that, I'm going to close the action. With the action closed, I'm going to now rotate that shotgun, and I'm going to reach inside of the loading port and access that cartridge stop, pressing it inward and allowing those shells to come out. Now, it's important to do this one at a time. You don't want to get overeager and try to control too many rounds at the same time, because it makes it difficult to control and you'll end up dropping rounds all over the place. Once I have all those rounds out of the magazine tube, I'm going to open the action, verify that the safety is still on, and give it one last check. I'm going to check both physically and visually the firing chamber and the magazine tube. Once I've checked and made sure that they're empty, I know that the shotgun is completely empty, it's safe, and it's ready to store. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.